But the angle isn't bad. We're just not. You need it, I guess.
No, the angle's good. The angle's good.
I just need it. You need it. Come in a little.
Well, the problem is, my neck and the guitar's gonna be right in your stomach.
This is.
Wishes were not. You're like, we have to, like, burn it.
Well, let you turn a little bit more. Not so in this room. I don't like what this humidity is doing to my hair.
Uh-oh.
You sound
like me. You sound like me when I'm in Florida.
We're going to be able to see those, I think, as long as we're close enough.
Sorry.
That's why, see, I'm way above you. That's why I was thinking you might want a pillow. Or stilts.
Represents our reputational hierarchy. Alright, I'll get a little. Let's use these two. Catch a boat to England.
You can stand up and I can sit. Ouch, that's kind of.
There's still a little bit of water on this floor, so just be mindful.
Henry just dropped his glass. They keep falling off.
Oh no.
My glasses fell off into my glass of water. Glasses
oh,
fell off into
a
glass.
What?
Hey,
you
think
better go buy a lottery ticket. That
I think we're on.
Today.
Are we on? I didn't mean to hit on. I think we're
oh,
a little
man,
early.
Oh,
what time is it?
It's.
What time is it, honey? My time.
It's.
Oh,
eight.
We're 5 minutes
it's,
early.
It's, yeah.
Well,
it's five.
Welcome
five
in.
Early.
Welcome, everyone. I guess we're on. This is truly a shit show. We'll just wait for people
best
to show
for
up.
A shit show.
It invites everyone into the process.
Yes. They can see the new pad. Let's see if I can show you. No, I don't know how to do any of this. Oh, like this. Let's see, the puppies are there. There's Lucius. Where's Lux?
Lux. In there?
She's probably in the hallway. There she is. Hey, Lux. Still moving in. This is Lucius's big bed. He sleeps in. And he's cool because he's got heterochromia. Bowie eyes. Right, Lucius? The new star of the show. Okay, well, people are coming. Welcome. Here's what we need to do. Start it early, so we... This is, it's outside our window. I have to check Lucius out. I don't know how I hit that. And we might be backwards, but that's the way it goes. And then, yes. Everybody get settled, take your seats. Welcome, it's hot here, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, no fan. Or...
Hi from Glasgow.
Glasgow.
Glasgow? Hey.
Thrum, do they know Thrum, our friends? Monica and Johnny? Love them. Love the step band. Shoot, what is the name of that band I really like? That's it's like a collective, and they do Boy with the Arab Strap. Tell me, people, what is it? Who am I forgetting?
I think it's good.
It's Boy with the Arab Strap. Who did that? The Pops, Dave Arnold. Yeah, is that Dave Arnold from Seattle? Mark Spitz. Oh, Mark Opitz. This is the late, great John Candy. Of course, keeping up with our Canadian content. I think we're just going to sit here the entire time and stare at you guys.
Hope everyone is surviving quarantine. And if you're out protesting, staying safe.
What? I don't know why you're...
Am I surviving quarantine?
Going a little nuts. You need to get out.
Yeah, I'm trashing the house.
Okay, we're up to 272. Two people left already. That was boring. We're bored.
Stop looking at that.
I know. Okay. It's not about size, doesn't matter. That's what you say, Steph.
It's true.
Well, maybe it's time. Is it 8 o'clock yet? I don't even know.
7:50.
It's time. It's
tis.
1 minute.
I'm not doing I'm not doing a cute little theme song tonight.
No.
Because I arrived here in Minneapolis. Moved back here last Wednesday. Right into the eye of the storm.
Two Wednesdays ago, right?
Yeah. Right into the eye of the storm with the George Floyd catastrophe, tragedy, and my little town I remembered is completely trashed. But it's also a good thing because it's brought everything that's been laying under the surface to the forefront.
Yeah.
So, out of something bad, hopefully something good will happen.
Well, you know, I think it's a time to reflect on how our own conditioning behaviors and just, you know, the system that we're in, how it's complicit in, you know, oppressing minorities and how we can go forward in that. And, you know, just want to extend all my support to people out there protesting. I hope everyone's staying safe and hopefully finally get heard.
Yeah, I mean, I just keep asking myself, I still can't believe it's 2020 and this is still happening. I mean, it's just mind-boggling to me. And makes that song, Sam Cooke song, I forget, did he write that? Who wrote The Change Is Gonna Come?
He wrote that.
I mean, it sounds so hopeful, and then we're still here. Now, what year was that? The 50s? Late 50s that song came out?
60? Yeah, somewhere between 59
and 61. Yeah, something like that. And we're still here. This is like, it's really a tragedy. So, this show, we're going to donate half of what we make to, I think this might be reversed, but we'll put it up somehow. We're going to do two of these. The JDocs put up a list of things that organizations or causes that we believe in. And for tonight, we're going to split whatever we make with Campaign Zero and Unicorn Riot. Campaign Zero is an online platform and organization that utilizes research-based policy solutions to end police brutality in America. And Unicorn Riot is a nonprofit organization that is dedicated to exposing root causes of dynamic social and environmental issues. So anything that is given to us, we will split with them. And the rest we will use to buy ourselves
food.
Some towels so we can be just like already all sweaty. All right?
It's pretty hot in this house.
It's a little hot now. Dad can't afford air conditioning at this point. It's cooling off tomorrow. That's right. It is cooling off tomorrow. What should we start with? Let's start with a JDoc song. We'll start stumbling through dark. You know, we're it's a loose affair. We just came into our living room, and it's a good way to say that we didn't practice real hard. Is that right? We practiced harder than the last time.
We still have yet to match the first time.
Yeah. So we're going to do a song from...
I think we're getting some comments that we're a little quiet.
A little quiet?
Yep. Yeah, so we'll talk up.
Well, we know that, you know, I will tell everyone that it's a work in progress, and now I'm in here, settled in Minneapolis. We should get a little closer. And we know our vocals sometimes are too quiet. I'm working on with my technical staff to get... a little more professional miking and video, so, but there's a certain charm to this. At least I keep telling myself that. So.
It is called The Shit Show.
It is. Oh, that's
at least we're self-aware.
Okay, this is called Stumbling Through the Dark. You're so in love. Yeah, you're gonna have to help with my high voice. I don't have it today. So you can maybe get vocal lessons from Tim O'Reilly.
Yeah, I know, we both. We both need vocal lessons from Tim O'Reilly.
O'Regan.
Did you hear me?
What?
Everyone's saying turn it up a bit.
Well, it's as loud as we can get, unless we get closer, and this is, but I think we need to get closer and not worry about how we look.
Aerodex
for dry. That's true. Aerodex, get a little closer.
And he needs a haircut.
Don't
that's true, I do need
a shy. Ashley Atkerson. All right, so let's do, another song. I'm going to do a song from the Vagabonds record, which I stole from, I didn't realize it, but I stole a lot of it from behind that locked door. Some of the chorus. She only calls me on Sundays. She's had her.
Seems like people can hear it better. So
yeah, that's because we're leaning.
Yeah,
I don't
think
they know what we look like. We're real pretty, but what do you want to do, Henry? Let's do a song that you sing. I'll pull out one of those.
Should
words.
We do one of the ones? Should we do every night? Should we
sure.
do the ones every
night? We'll do a happy one. We got a lot of sad ones tonight.
New song heard on WYEP in Pittsburgh.
New song. Yeah, that's another thing I want to do is start doing.
Me, you.
Yeah.
You and me? Okay.
We started going through the McCartney, the Beatles solo records, starting with the very first. And then Lennon and some Harrison. Consensus was Lennon was the one that never made a really bad record. McCartney made some great ones, and that's so good.
I don't think you listened to all the Lennon ones, though. I'm not sure.
No.
I know sometime in New York City is supposed to not be very good, but I didn't listen to that one.
Well, I still think Mark McCartney has such highs, but he also has such lows, and Lennon seems to have lesser lows, and Harrison maybe made the best Beatles solo record of all, but then he had, what was the one after that?
Living in Material
World.
Yeah,
then it kind of pretty
that
spotty.
That one's pretty good, too.
Of course, my stuff's spotty, too. So we're doing
this
one.
Dark Horse was not good.
Okay, but this song, we can't get out of our heads, especially, believe my mama.
This is a good McCartney track.
So you do the verse, I do the second part, then I do the verse. Okay.
Right.
Because you hate that next verse.
I have one of my least favorite lyrics. Yeah.
Okay, I got it. Something like that. I don't know if I'll get that.
That's like I'll say. All right.
Ready? Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry.
All right, we'll start again.
Okay.
It's like they get in a rehearsal. All right.
It worked in rehearsal.
Get out of my head. Every every day I lay on my pillow, I'm resting my mind. Every morning brings a new day. Every night that day is through. But tonight I just want to stay in and be with you. And be with you.
That song when it came out.
Yeah, but and
now they're in a Geico commercial.
Who else? There's something else that's stuck in there, isn't it?
Yeah, this one.
Can't remember. What do you want to do next?
Nailing it.
Huh?
Just reading comments. Nailing it.
Okay, we're gonna do this. Yeah, we're gonna do a song called "Working Girl." That was a B-side on my solo record. I did it in Spain with my good friend Paco Loco. And it's still really, I like it better than the rest of my solo record. I have a hard time playing those songs. Let's see if I can do this without looking at the lyrics.
Do you want the lyrics? Do you have them?
You can turn them up. It's just a crutch. Okay, it's a crutch. It's like religion. Just like religion. Ready? Thank you.
Yeah.
The recording is really good. It's a really sweet recording. Yeah. So, good night, everyone. No, I'm kidding. We're going to keep going. What else are we going to do?
Somebody's asked if we can hear a sneak peek from the new album.
Well, we played it in other shows, but,
a sneak peek of your solo album coming up.
Yeah, we're going to do a song on my solo record, which has been held because the day hook's a big deal. I got the record up first.
Similar conundrum to the first McCartney solo record, actually.
Is it? Yeah, we're so much alike, it's crazy. I mean, what can I say? Step aside for the Jayhawks, whatever the Jayhawks. No, I'm kidding. There was no rush for this. Just a little record I did that happens to be amazing. That's a song about, you know, I'm 65. I know I look 64, 66-ish, but I still don't really exactly know what I believe in, which just drives me nuts sometimes. It's called Living in Between. when I bump you like that means we're getting close to it. Yeah, that's the first time we did that, and hopefully not the last.
I love that song.
I like the lyrics. I sometimes I'm like, man, not so bad. Not so bad, Gary. Let's do it. You ready to do that?
Where's that towel?
Right there. Here's your towel. I know.
Someone wants you to name a tune from your teenage years that you love.
Teenage years? I think it was the Al Jolson. No, I'm kidding. Something from the 30s. I was going to make jokes about how old I was. I mean, I love the Beatles. I was really into The Who, you know, growing up. The Who and the Kinks, you know, particular songs. You know, 60s, Sitting on the Dock of the Bay. That's a good question. I remember really being into Lean On Me by Bill Withers. And anyway, I'll think about that. Let's do that. I'm going to do a Radiohead song now.
I need the lyrics for this.
Yeah, it's
far away. Oh, yeah. I might sit a little bit back because I do have to kind of yell it at
the end of that. It's, play. I kind of know this one. Of course, I haven't really been that spot on in any of them yet. So.
The timing's a little tricky on this, though.
Yeah, I'm going to let you take that one part because we practiced like twice.
Okay.
Get close to the.
All right. Wake from your sleep.
This is kind of slow.
Just try.
I think she needs to be a little slower, right?
Oh, you know.
Wow.
He didn't screw up the timing too badly.
That's because I stopped buying in certain parts of
Henry, that was amazing.
Thank you.
Every time I hear that song, ever since I first... And it's Tom York and Radiohead always, you know, I love that band, and sometimes when they're interviewed, you're kind of hoping they're going to say something like, but I really like, you know, something completely different than what they do. I'm going to maybe surprise you, like, by the Jayhawks, or some, you know, some words or something.
Oh, that's the real
and
reason.
Then every time, yeah, and then when you read it, it's all this crazy, arty stuff that I'm fairly versed on, so I've never heard half any of it. But I will say, and that song always reminds me, I did it my way. So that makes me think of my way every time. Okay. So we can do an old Jack song. I can pull up Dead Angel, because it seems appropriate. This was on Blue Earth Records, right?
Sorry, I didn't know.
You didn't know that one?
Although I messed up the chords a few times.
I know.
But
so did I. So did I. That's all right. It's okay.
Rocky,
it is interesting, though. I wasn't even thinking about it, and I had requested that we play that song soon, and the lyrics ended up being really fitting.
I know. That's why we do it, because we're here to remember that the city has been kind of opened up like a wound, you know, that's been festering. And I can't imagine. I have a friend, Elizabeth, who has two adopted African-American children, and she tells me about how the things people say to her, and I still can't believe it. I can't believe the divide. I just cannot. I don't know. And when I first moved here in 73, it was like all white Scandinavian, and this town has become so much more diverse and interesting, and now whenever anybody sees a police car, you look at it in a totally different way, like a lot of African Americans have been doing for quite a while. Okay, what else? We're getting some not gonna look at numbers. I don't care how many people. It's all about making people.
It's all good. The Gibson sounds so good.
The Gibson. I think I got spoiled by the first show where there's so many.
It's the guy playing.
You want to do another song, Henry? What else do you have on your back? Do you want to do that, or do you want to do some? Or do you feel like you've done your songs?
We can. You want to space it out more, or do you want to try this one now?
Which one, Stan? Yeah, sure, we'll try it.
Okay. Or do you want to space it out with something else?
Let's space it out with something else, and then let's do Strangers.
Okay.
So, to my lovely Steph, this goes out to you. I'm coming to Canada. They better let me in, because I am.
They better. I'm waiting.
Yes, I know. You need me to nurse you back to health.
Let's get more sleep.
Yes. You can help me.
We are one.
starting to look at the lyrics, but I haven't done this since.
And then I should drag it further over.
That was in the way, so I was like, yeah, yeah. I think I'd be better standing up anyway.
You do the Lennon knees.
What's that?
You know, where he like bends his knees, like he like goes up and down while he plays.
Really?
Yeah.
Me and Lennon. We got a real good thing.
What we got next?
What's happening next?
I don't know. Put it in Susan.
Everyone was digging that.
Django! Django, baby! It's loose, you know? I mean, I just got a mop and a vacuum cleaner. Still waiting on plates, so we're pulling it together. But I wanted to do one before I went to Canada, then Henry will be here, hopefully, for a good part of July. We'll see. And if not, he won't. But if he's here, we'll do more. What else? What do people want to know? Pisces, I'm 6'2", 175. I like long walks in the rain.
Will you be joining Craig and streaming from his studio?
No.
Is a question.
You know, at some point, I love Craig, but right now it's not real. I don't feel comfortable going into spaces like that. I mean, that's the one thing that freaked me out about the protest was just kind of all these people right next to each other, where I've been so trained to just stay away. Even living up in upstate New York, you just... People would be walking down the road and they, in the country, and they kind of move away from you. Just the proximity scared me a little bit. But with Craig, yes, we will do things, and hopefully we'll get Mark Perlman and Tim and Karen at some point to sit in when things are a little bit better here.
Sure. What are we doing?
Just give a second here, take a breath, because it's not all about the show, it's about the experience. So again, for any of you guys who tuned in late,
yeah, introduce them to the dogs.
You're going to see Lucius here is laying. Yeah, he's laying here, right, Lush? A little confused, are you? Little blue and brown eyes. Sweetie. Yes. And, we'll check out where Lux is over here. Still moving in. There's Lux, right? She's out in the back. She's smart. She's the smart laying in where it's cool. And this is where the prince and princess sleep. Just thought you'd like to little, you know, see my situation right now. I know, thank you for that.
Yeah, where did you get that from?
A special woman from Canada. I'm going to see. You better let me in.
I'm coming.
Oh, what else do we have here, people? Let's do a... help me
if
out. Think about it.
Oh, right.
Nice and easy.
Pills and magazines, left her lying in her misery.
promos. And back off a little bit here.
I gotta love the guy.
Someone wrote Medicine for the Soul. Thank you.
This could be a disaster, or most likely it'll be somewhere in between a disaster and something good.
I can't wait.
Yeah.
Nice try.
When you talk about growing up and what were some of my favorite songs, you know, when I was 14 is when Woodstock happened. And although I wasn't there, I went to see the movie 14 times and used to stand in front of the mirror in my white elephant bells and like trying to beat Pete Townsend or Alvin Lee or, you know. But the Sly the Family Stone, kind of, people say, you know, Santana stole it or whatever, but I thought Sly was the coolest thing there. Keys this in.
I think we're doing a half step down from the original for my vocal stake. Just for vocal stake.
Okay, I'll get. And what's that weird thing that goes to the instrumental thing? Is that
it just walks up, but then there's a half step?
On the instrumental? At the end.
Yeah, we don't have to do that. You could just sing that.
Okay, we'll figure it out. Okay.
All right.
What fun would it be if we rehearsed and had it perfect?
We should do it. We need to do one.
That was fun.
Yeah, we'll rehearse really hard for one of them, but not this one. Okay.
Stand in the end.
Showtime. So it's getting about that time. We started a few minutes early, so does anything else anybody really wants to hear?
Everyone's just loving all of this.
Much better than expected. Thank you.
Who said that?
I mean, that's a fair comment. Better than I expected.
No, it's also way to go, Henry.
No one can match Sly.
Henry. I'm just letting him be shadow now.
Oh, gosh.
So well, everybody.
Not you.
Very tough choice, yeah. He nailed it.
You know, Vagabonds? No, not really. Let's not do it.
Well, speaking of, it's in Spotlight. That's a Spotlight song. I'll do a solo to end it.
Not without you. I can't do something without you.
You can do this one here. Yes, I saw somebody say Rod Stewart. Well, technically, the great, late, great Tim Hardin wrote that song, along with If I Were a Carpenter and Misty Roses, so many great songs. Anyway, thank you all. Keep the faith. We love you. And we'll do this again in a little while. Thank you all. Bye,
goodbye from Minneapolis.